Hi friends, in this video we are discussing fitting a nonlinear curve y is equal to a b power x. In the earlier videos we have discussed the fitting of a linear curve y is equal to a plus b power x and y is equal to a plus bx plus cx square. Here degree is 1, so it is a linear. Rest of all other nonlinear. For example, y is equal to a plus bx plus cx square is nonlinear, and y is equal to a b power x, y is equal to ax power b are nonlinear equations. Now you see, before fitting, what we requirements? Normal equations we are required. Okay, normal equation how we will get? In the previously we are discussed for these two. Now we are discussing for this one. Here you observe it is a product of two cons. A and B are two unknowns. Here dot product is there. So better to go for the x is in powers. So better to apply log on both sides. Now applying log on both sides. Then log y is equal to log a b power x. So this is equal to, this is product of two terms. Okay, now log a b, we know na? Log a plus log b, like that. Log a plus log b to the power of x. Next, this is equal to log a plus log here if you have like x power n is equal to n log x are not here. So same formula. Then x log b, which value this is? Log y values. So here you observe, now it is addition of terms are not here. Now this is, I am considering as capital Y, and this is capital A, plus x is the small x is small x, because they are given x comma y values, but here you have capital Y, you have log Y you have, that is why I am considering as a capital Y. Next, small x is small x only. Now log B you consider as a capital B. See, this is a straight line. This is a straight line. Yeah, what straight line normal equations, you know very well, na? What are the straight line normal equations? How we are done? We are multiply with the A equation and some B equation. Then you will get the normal equations. Then what values you will have? Capital A and capital B. But which value you required for this curve? Y is equal to A B power X, small A and small B. How we will get small A and small B means? Here what we consider? Capital A as a log small A. So I want small a is nothing but anti log is nothing but log a base e. We are done here. Log a base e. If you have taken base 10, then anti logarithm is 10 power. Okay. Now this is e power capital A. Then you will have small a. Similarly, capital B is equal to what we have? Log b. That implies small b is equal to anti logarithm. If you are applied, small b is equal to, this is small b. Small b is equal to e to the power of capital B. Now tell me, what are the normal equations for a plus xb? How many we will have? 2. So first, to get the first equation, what you have to do? Multiply with the 1, summation 1. Then summation 1 into capital Y means capital Y is equal to summation 1 into a. Capital A is a. Summation 1, what you have to consider as? Summation 1 is n only, now. We are discussed in previous video also. Okay. Means n, here n is nothing but it represent how many number of observations. Okay, now that is, if you are added n observations are there, you can say summation 1 is n. If 3 observations are there, summation 1 is 3, right? Now in this case, n a plus summation 1 into x is nothing but summation x. B is a constant, write down outside, then summation x. Next, second equation, how we will get? Multiply b equation, that is small x. So summation small x into capital Y is equal to, this is n a, remember. Now capital A into summation small x plus b into summation x square, small x square only. Which values you know? Actually we know only small x and small y, but here what you required, you tell me? Cap summation small x, next summation x square, next summation capital Y, next summation small x capital Y. What is mean by capital Y here? Capital Y is nothing but a log y. Okay, you know only small y. How you will get capital Y? Now you have to apply capital Y is nothing but log for small y. That is nothing but capital Y is equal to log y. So we have to take this value and this value. We won't consider these y values. We have to, after transformation of nothing but, we have to take capital Y values only. Now you see, if you are added, then you will have small summation x. If you are added this is these all values, then you will have capital Y, na? Next, which one you required? X square. X square is just, you multiply x square you will have. Next, small x capital Y. Here you have small x, here you have capital X, capital Y. So multiply, then you will have small x capital Y. Now draw the table for this. In these boxes we need to write x1, x2, x3, so on, xn. then y1, y2, y3, so on, yn. These values they will give in the problem. Okay, now what you require actually? Capital Y. Capital Y, how we will have? Log small y. So apply log for this. Log of y1, log y2, log y3, so on, log yn. Then you will have capital y1, capital y2, so on, capital yn. Next, x square, you know, x1 square, x2 square, so on, xn square. Next, small x, capital Y. Small x, capital Y. Small x1, capital y1. Small x2, capital y2, so on, small xn, capital yn. Then you will have, if you are added these all, then you will have summation small x. This, are you required this one? No, we are not required here. So this is summation capital Y, and this is summation x square, summation small x capital Y. Substitute these all values in normal equations. Then you will have which value? Capital A and capital B. Here unknowns, what you have? Capital A and capital B. But what you require? Small a and small b. So how you will get small a and small b means capital A you consider as the log A, na? So log A is equal to capital A. Now if you are applied anti-log, that is nothing but e power capital A will become small a. Similarly, e power capital B will become small b. E power capital B will become small b. Then you substitute capital A and capital B values in this equation, small a and small b values in the equation 1. Then you will get the solution.